Hello guys, and welcome to another game of Hexxit from the Technic Launcher. And today we're going to be doing something a little different with Hexxit. And today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make an awesome house in Tekkit. Or Hexxit. Why do I keep saying Tekkit? Hexxit. And Hexxit is sort of, you know, an RPG style modpack from the Technic Launcher, and so we're going to want to make sort of a medieval RPG style house for all your stuff. Now, you could gather the materials and do this in survival, but it would take forever. So I'm just going to do it in creative, and then on my Let's Plays of Hexxit, I think we'll be using this house as our base to then go explore. And there's already one Let's Play out where we kind of just walk around the map and look at some things preliminarily. And then also, if you would like to install Hexxit and you don't know how to do it yourself, I have a video on how to install it. So without further ado, let's get started. And first few things you're going to want are some basic materials: oak, wood, and cobble. And normally, normally I'm pretty picky about my texture packs, but I couldn't find a good texture pack for Hexxit yet, so we're going to use the default one, which kind of makes me mad, but it's Hexxit, so there's lots of other things to make that look cool. And we're going to try to take advantage of a lot of the new blocks within Hexxit. And I've been playing Hexxit for a total of maybe 30 minutes, and so we'll see what we can do. I do have experience, though, building medieval things, and I have some other videos of some of my builds if you'd like to check those out. So far we've just been using some plain materials. We haven't used the wood yet. So what you're going to want to do to start off is you're going to want to start off with a foundation and just make columns, maybe four, three if you want a little shorter, but I would go with about four high. And then please don't like copy the exact, you know, form of this house. You should make something that's more original than just sort of a square kind of thing and then a little entrance coming off. I would recommend making, yeah, like I said, more variety, lots of entrances and things coming off of it. And then you're just going to want to sort of, you know, lay these out as a foundation. And then once you have your foundation, you're going to want to place oak like this. That way we can expand upwards later. You'll see what I'm talking about in a few minutes when we start expanding this house upwards. So, here we can see that I indented these walls right here. And I didn't do that here just because there wasn't much space to indent, but it looks a lot better, I think, if you indent, especially later, because it really gives the build more depth. And if everything's flush with this, it looks like you made it on survival. It'll look terrible. So you really should have depth. You don't have to put depth in here, but you should try to include as much depth in your build. And so generally with my builds, I make sort of an outline like this first, and then I go over in detail it more. So to do some of the detailing, we're gonna wanna go around and place blocks like this around some of the walls. This usually looks pretty good for detailing. You'll see what I'm going to do in a little bit. Let's see. You know, it probably doesn't matter if I don't put anything. Well, yeah, I think I will put something there. All right. Now let's start here. Yeah, it's always important to add tons of detail to the build, and most builds, I think, will not look very good until the last, you know, few steps while you're detailing. but you could also just sort of, you know, detail along the, oops, what did I just load there? You can sort of detail along the way, if you want, like I'm doing. So I'm gonna grab some, stone stairs and place them on top of each of these little columns. And I really like this because the stairs add a little bit of detail, and at the same time, it adds a lot of depth to the build. So you have it indented, and then you have these, you know, pillars coming out that look sort of like supports, maybe. And that really, really helps with your build. And by the way, guys, if you know you want to build this in a different game, you could definitely build this in something, I don't know. Well, you could definitely build this in, say, just normal, you know, Minecraft or on creative, if you have a server or something. Just exclude all of the things that I use for Hexxit. But I'm going to try to use as much, or as many new Hexxit things as possible, especially when we do the detailing stage. Although, right now, we're just going to go type in oak and then grab some of these oak stairs. You can see we've got tons of cool furniture. Our interiors will be awesome. So I think for this video, we're probably just going to... we're probably just going to do the exterior of it, and then we can work on the interior and some of the other things. So I think we're going to grab some other different things. It's always good to, when you're making a build like this, experiment with how these things look and play out, because you may have a great idea and then you know put it into practice and it ends up just looking terrible. So you always want to be checking. Now, I'm not sure that's going to look great. Yeah, to be honest, that does not look that great, so it's going to get vetoed. So I think what I might do is actually expand this a little and make these 5 high. And you'll see why I'm going to do that in a second. But you could definitely do this just doing them 4 high. It all depends on, you know, how you would like it to look. So we're not going to expand the cobble up, but we are going to expand these oak posts up. Now you could use spruce or something for this, but I think oak generally looks pretty good, and depending on what texture pack you have, spruce may look really different, but oak should be about the same. Okay. So now that we've gone through and done that, and I don't like putting side ones on these corners because what I'm going to do is expand this into a small tower later. This is sort of the foundation for a tower that's going to split off of the main house. And then these right here do have two on them, two, you know, things coming out, because we want them to capture the wall within that, whereas this just will have, you know, one piece of wall between it. So, let's see. For the next level, I think we're going to want a intermediate layer between the two levels of stone brick. So I'm just going to search stone in here. See, sometimes you grab the monster eggs. I've done that a couple times. Then you have to use, like, world edit and change everything and build back to normal bricks. That can be a total pain. Okay, so now you're going to want to expand this out a little, and you can really expand this out in a lot of different ways. So the way I'm going to expand it out is just simply placing stone bricks here, and this is a very simple way of expanding it out. You might want to use stairs. I'm not sure. I might use these stairs, but it really depends. I mean, this is definitely a fine way of expanding it out. You might think that it looks, I don't know, kind of plain right now, but it'll definitely take shape as we continue in the video. So let's just continue placing these around. Okay. And I generally like to start with using sort of stone cobble for the foundation because it seems more sturdy than using wood. And if you use wood for your entire build, you're just not going to have the variation that will look nice. And also, most houses are not made entirely of stone. You know, they might have a foundation of stone, but they're made entirely of stone. So before we continue with the rest of the house, we're going to want to continue these pillars. And it's always a good idea to continue your pillars before you start building the rest of your house, because then you know you have basically an outline, and it's much easier to fill in an outline than try to guess what, you know, you're going to do with the outline. And let's see, I might put a one there. Yeah, I think that'll look better. She will it? I can figure out what to do with that later. You can always sort of tweak these things later when you go into the detailing stage, but it's much better to, you know, just get a foundation and then, you know, spend tons and tons of time trying to get everything perfect in the beginning. So, we can see we have sort of what looks looking more like a house now. And so now we're going to want to continue these out. I generally like to make the stages smaller or the same size. I wouldn't make like the bottom stage, you know, three high and then the second stage four high, because that would look kind of weird normally, depending on what you're trying to do. Sometimes if you have a small foundation, you can do that, but the general rule I would say is you're going up, the level should get smaller or at least stay the same. And so you kind of want to keep that in mind, and it's usually will do you well. So I'm not quite sure how we want to continue this out, but I think we're gonna want to do it like this. And the only reason I'm making these have two things coming out is because this is gonna be part of the tower and it'll look better for the tower. But normally I wouldn't do that. And I'm adding a tower because if you add, you know, little things like towers that add variation to your build, it'll look really good. You can't just put tons of minor detail because it'll look really excessive and kind of, I don't know, like you just stuck a bunch of detail on there. You have to have, you know, variation within your actual structure. So now let's fill this in with some wood. Now I'm going to use a style that I really like to use, but you know, obviously if you want to use some different types of wood or you want to use some different technique for making the walls and the sides, I'm going to come back to the tower because it's probably going to be a bit different. Then, you know, go right ahead. You can, you know, copy this exactly block for block. But the point of this tutorial is to kind of show you some techniques that you can use yourself, and then yeah, go build these yourself. So I think, although that doesn't look the greatest, I think we're gonna want to add something like that there, and then maybe add a support coming down. So real quick, we're gonna jump over to grab some cobble fences. I think this will look good. It's often good to have supports like this. See, that really adds some depth to it. I wasn't really liking that corner before. And then you can put maybe some stairs like that. Yeah, that's starting to look better. Okay. And we should probably do that for this side as well. Although it looks kind of weird, people, when you know they just see it without having built it before, they'll think that looks pretty good. So let's see. Now we can go add some here. You'll see why I'm doing wood on the sides like this in a little bit. Think we'll add some wood right here. Actually, that's going to be kind of unnecessary. We'll add wood right here and right here. Yeah, that'll be good. Okay, so now we're going to want to use a technique I really like to use, but I don't know about you guys, so just going to grab some wool here. Was that spectral wool? No, we're just going to want to get normal wool and normal gray wool, and then go around and add, like, sort of like this. Now, there are a lot of different things you can do with this, so one of the things I like doing is not having just straight walls and putting things like this in here. And so, feel free, you know, not to do this, because this is a technique I sometimes use, you know, if you have very flat walls like this. We'll get back to that later. But I think it ends up working out pretty well. So on the, I'm not going to do it on these smaller ones because it would kind of kill them, but on these bigger ones it definitely adds a lot of variation. Let's change the time. Okay. And you'll see what I'm going to do with the gray wool in a second. It's, once again, just to add variation, and you'll see. So that's going to look... Wow, it usually looks so much better on texture packs. Now, texture packs I would recommend for a medieval build like this. I'm not sure if this will actually be compatible with Hexxit or not, but John Smith is definitely an excellent option if you're considering making a build like this. Let's see, I think we went a little... Well, all right. So then we're going to grab some glass. And basic glass wall, reinforced glass wall. I think we're just going to want the normal glass or the glass pane. I'm going to grab the glass pane because it'll, once again, add more depth. And the purpose of this right here is just to be a window. With John Smith, I might actually use the just the glass because it looks pretty nice. But you never know. So there we go. And I think we're going to want to do something similar over here. Let's see. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's going to end up looking better over here because it will look kind of stretched out. And, this type of window is pretty good because it's... If you make a rectangle window, I mean, that's perfectly fine in most cases. But, I think that's probably what I'm going to do here. But I'm going to show you, if you go like this, and then like this... and then you put in glass blocks, then it makes kind of a nice window like that. Okay, so we've made most of the exterior for the second story. Now we're going to want to figure out what we want to do with these areas over here. So I might recommend... So some things you could do, I'm going to show you a couple things. You could do sort of what we do with that other window there, and then, you know, put in glass. Looks okay. You could also go like this, and then put in, I'm going to put glass right here, but I would recommend if you do this, put two panes here instead. It'll add more depth. You could also go like this, or like this. Whatever you think looks best. I think I'm going to go with this option and then put glass panes here. But honestly, this may not be the best looking option, but I think it'll work. So then over here, let's see, what can we do over here? I think we should go like this and then like this. And then add some glass blocks. Let's see, I'm really lazy. I should just add both glass blocks and panes to my inventory. Okay, so then over on this side, let's see. Maybe on this side we won't add windows because we don't want too many windows in our build. It would get kind of old. Maybe we'll just do that. And then over here, maybe we won't add windows again, and we'll just... Let's get rid of this, because that's kind of weird. I think maybe we'll just sort of add wool like so. Put a some wood there. Okay, so now what you're going to want to do with your wool, because white wool by itself looks kind of boring and it really stands out, we need to get a texture pack that makes this wood sort of duller. It's really pretty bright white right now. But you're going to want to sort of replace roughly a third of the white wool with gray. Obviously, I'm not doing the math. I'm really just making this totally random. And that sort of randomizes it. It's a technique called randomizing it. Randomizing, believe it or not, I didn't actually make that up. And it really adds a lot of, you know, detail to the build. And when you look at it from sort of farther away, you can tell that although you can, you know, see the different colors, in your mind they sort of blend together more. And it allows you to see sort of a mix of the two colors, which really helps for a better experience, you know, more variety, more detail, right? So, I think we're done there. Now we just have to worry about the tower. Now, for the tower, I think we're going to want to add some detail coming off of it. So, let's get rid of the oak slab, because we're probably not going to use that. And let's go cobble. And let's grab some of these. And put these coming down. And then we are going to, I think we're just going to go with wool on this one. Actually, I should probably go with some wood on this one. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Should probably go with some wood. And then put like a wood block there. I'm not sure if I really like that or if I hate it. Let's see. I think I can live with that, but I think to make it look like more of a sphere, we're going to want to go get some fence. Whoa, there are a lot of fences. I think we're going to want to actually just grab the normal fence and put it like this. Maybe. No. Well, actually. Yeah, I guess we'll do that. And then this will be the base for our tower. So, guys, this was the first real building video I've done. So I hope you like it. We're not done quite yet. But this is definitely going to be in more than one episode. So, let's open up, let's see, how do we open up this stupid thing? See, I had it open a second ago, and, enabled, Minecraft layout, cheat mode, okay, interesting. Oh, I guess they just grouped it into here because we're on creative. So, let's go to, how do we go to the normal blocks? Alright. So they should have included the newer building blocks, yes? Well, then I think we're going to have to go over here. So dungeon generators, extra biomes. Ah, perfect. So now we're going to look through and see if there's anything we want to utilize in the rest of the exterior of our build. Oh, Scarecrow, that's pretty cool. I want to utilize that later. Red cobblestone, that could be nice. Let's think. So I think we might want to do like a red cobble roof, I'm thinking. Normally I would do sort of a spruce roof, but I think that will be nice. I really like these variety of leaves. Okay, so for the second story, we're going to want to do something pretty similar. And we're just going to continue this up. And if you make this more than two stories, you may want to add some variation. Because if you just have it, you know, coming out like this, and you don't really add any variation, the build will look kind of repetitive. Also might look pretty tall. And coming out, although it's kind of stupid, like you would probably not have a build in real life that, you know, fans out this much. You want to exaggerate everything in Minecraft, especially when you're working with like medieval fantasy kind of things. You really just want to exaggerate everything for people to see it. So, alright, let's see. We could look at our selection of extravagant woods. Acacia, fir, and redwood. Alright, let's see. I'm just going to take a wild guess. Let's go with fir. Fir. Alright, so we're just going to get rid of some of this real quick. And then grab some of these fir things. Okay. So, I think... Actually, I'm not sure about that fir. Will that look good? No, I don't think we're going to want to use fir. And let's also change the time. Time set 0. Okay. Let's use redwood. I bet that ends up looking better. Alright, so redwood. And should be some redwood stairs. There we go. Dad will need slabs for right now. So, just put something like this. Generally, although I did it here because we didn't have too much space, you don't want to just jump from one level to the next. You want to have some sort of transition blocks. These are what I like to call transition blocks. And actually, in fact, we could even do something there if we go grab some stone brick stairs and do something like that or like that. It looks okay. I think we maybe could do that around the edges. Totally up to you guys. Once again, that kind of adds a bit more depth. And we'll go over adding, you know, more depth and stuff in the detailing stage, because obviously we're going to be doing more of this. But you can see it's looking okay. All right. So now we're going to just want to go do that with the redwoods all around. So see, we did it there. Now I guess we're going to want to come do some here. So I'm worried the redwood's going to end up, well, I know it sounds stupid, but looking too reddish. Because we're going to want a contrast between it and the red roof. So we might actually want to use the acacia. That's what, here, let's just look. Because it always looks different when you look at the item. Then. You know, acacia might actually, I know I've been second-guessing myself, but I know acacia actually might be better than redwood. Yeah, I think it will be. Alright, this is the last time I'm going to change blocks. So if this looks terrible, we're just going to go with it. But I think it'll look okay. Looks a lot like the like birch things, which I normally don't like, but whatever. And guys, if you really don't like this, please just use a different material. And don't like in the comments, Why did you choose that material? I don't entirely know what I'm doing with Hexxit, but I can definitely give you guys some good building techniques, just in general, so. Alright, I think we're going to do that. That's kind of... gray area. Anyways, now I think we're just going to want to just continue this up a little. Just thinking right here. Yeah. Alright, we're going to want to continue this up. Similar style as we did with the other one. And this time, let's see if we... okay. So here's a style you can use. I like it a lot. It really adds a lot of depth, so, you know, putting the blocks and then the stairs like that usually is pretty good. Although it might end up making it too tall, but, you know, whatever. We're just experimenting here. Okay. Now I think we're gonna have to. Yeah, I think we're just gonna wanna maybe skip it on this one, and then just go like that, just because it wouldn't look that great doing that technique there. So then here we can, what did I just get rid of? Some wool. Gotta be careful because sometimes you delete blocks, and then you don't really realize it later, and then it becomes a problem. Done that in a lot of my things, and it's not until, you know, the video of me showcasing it that I actually realize I made the mistake, and that's just not good, so try to avoid it. Okay, so now I think on this one we're just gonna wanna we kind of have a problem because of this thing right there. I think we're just gonna I'm not gonna bother using a slab, we're just gonna want to cover that. Okay, and then maybe we could actually do that. Not sure which looks better. I think we'll just be safe and leave it like that for now. Well, that was a weird sound. Oh, it's an Enderman. You can see all my gravestones from playing on survival. So, yeah, I think we're just gonna wanna continue this up right here. And then do the same right here. Actually, that might have been a little. So one thing we can take advantage of right now is go search fence again and then find the Acadia fence. So I think this is it, probably. Which definitely looks like it. Is that it? Not entirely sure that's it, actually. Might be that one, although that one looks kind of weird. But I guess we won't find out unless we try it. Nope, definitely this one. Okay, so I'm gonna put that there. Just to sort of, one, to give it more detail, and to look like this block is being, you know, more supported. Maybe we should only put one. Well, actually, it probably doesn't really matter. Alright, so, it's kind of tricky having corners like this, but I think that will be the best. We're not going to want to, like, put something like that. Those actually, these, as much as people think they look good, rarely do they really look good. So, it's generally best to just stay with the corner like that. Then I would recommend, let's see, yeah, probably like that, and then put, see, we're gonna have that gap right there, so we need to cover that somehow. You could just put blocks instead of stairs, and I might change that anyways when doing the interior. Maybe we should some blocks like that. Yeah, might as well. Okay. Now, here we have another really nice long section. So, just do this again, like before. And, maybe we'll continue this out with two blocks, just because it's going to be really long. So, and what we can actually do is go like this. Now, if you have both stairs facing the same way, it's not going to look as good because it looks like an upside-down staircase and it's just not visually appealing. I'm not entirely sure why, but it's just not, so don't do it. And then we want to get rid of the gap there above the window, so we'll put that. It's lagging a bit. Anyways, alright, now let's finish over here, and just put something like that. Yeah, I think that will be okay. Then just, you know, continue this across. Music. Why? And yeah, the inside looks terrible, but we'll be fixing that in a little bit. So, let's see. Actually, that'll definitely be in the next video. Yeah, I think that'll look okay for now. So now for the tower. I think I'm just going to put some blocks like this right here. Then I think I'm going to do that. We don't actually need that block, but whatever. And I think we'll keep it like that for now. We might change some things on the tower a bit later, but that should be okay for now. So now I'm just going to go and put some things like this. Yeah, we'll deal with these little end things later. For this one, we might... Yeah, I think we'll come back to these smaller ones. Though we might put one here. And I think we'll come back to that one as well. Yeah, I think we might want to do something like that. Okay, so for this one, we're going to want to go grab more of our trusty gray and gray wool, because we already have the other wool. Okay, time. No. Never want to start with gray wool. So something you can do that sometimes looks nice, we're going to see if this works, is add another layer like this. And then add, see where the Acadia woods are, there we go. Yeah, actually in that case it doesn't really look that great, maybe this. Yeah, I don't really think so. I think we're just going to want to do wool. Alright. I think we're going to want to add another here just to make it look better. Generally, symmetry isn't good, but in this case, I think it is. And then we'll put this there so the corner isn't as annoying looking. We'll come back to that later. Yeah, that's looking a little better. Alright, now we can go through and add some of our gray wool. Okay, so just basically just totally randomize this. Called randomizing, actually is called randomizing. Okay, now maybe we'll come back and do this one real quick. Alright, so now for the like corners that I've been skipping the entire time. So for these, I think what we're going to want to do is extend this out. Then extend this, and then that. Yeah, we're going to want to do that. Okay. And, then just extend this out to the top and put maybe like that, and then one. Something like that. You could add a window there, but I think it's kind of too small a space to add a window. So we're just not going to add a window. But yeah. And then, yeah, I think that's good. Good enough for now, at least. All right, now to finish on this one. So, I think we're going to put a window here. I think we are. And generally, as you go up, you put less windows, but obviously that depends on the style of your house. But I would just take that as a general rule. All right, so... All right, so this next story is sort of the attic type story, which doesn't mean it's small. I think this attic will probably be fairly large because we want the roof to be pretty intricate looking. And you'll see why I'm saying that in a second. Okay, so for the roof, you're going to want to extend up. Actually, no, first you're going to want to extend out, although that is looking a little repetitive. Yeah, first, we're actually going to extend in. This will get rid of how repetitive it looks. Yeah, and it'll make our roof a bit smaller. Because I think we don't want it quite this big. So you're going to want to extend in. And I am going to extend it on both sides here just because there's a tower. Then, not going to extend in there. And extend in there, and I think we'll be okay. Okay, so what you're then going to want to do, and I'll show you a small example here, is extend this up 3-ish. You could do extend up 2, depending on how tall you want your roof to be, and then extend that up 2, or you could even extend that up 3. Actually, because the other roofs are going to be... Other parts of the roof are going to be pretty tall. I think I'm going to actually extend that up to there. Okay, now you're going to want to extend this part up. I'm not going to quite extend this up quite as fast, because otherwise it would be super tall. You don't want the roof to be all at the same level, but you definitely don't want, you know, one side 30 blocks above the other one. That would look awful. So, yeah. And let's even just get rid of that. So, yeah, that's gonna look better. We'll deal with the tower in a second, because I'll show you there's some special things we have to do with that. That are different than just extending up these eaves normally. Oh. This is gonna be pretty high. So, if you don't want to make it quite this high, we could see about just going like that. Yeah, I think that'll look a lot better once we put that on the roof, but I think that's what we're going to want to do. Yeah, so I think that should be good for that part. And this we will deal with later. So now let's talk about the tower. So, with the tower, the main parts of the tower, let's see. You actually have to think when you're making a tower. So here's the center of the tower. Let's just continue this up. Although we will definitely get rid of this later. Right, so this is the center of the tower. So three blocks away. So you always want to keep your, tower symmetrical from the inside as well. But let's say we want this whole bottom to be, a nice living room or something like that. You don't have to extend this tower support from the very bottom, and I'm not. I'm gonna start the tower support up there somewhere. That's just a rough outline for now, but let's see, is that three? Yeah, okay. So, I mean, you could start it from the bottom, but I personally don't think you should, because it'll kind of mess up whatever you're doing with the rooms. Okay. So that's going to be a fairly large tower. Normally, you'd probably want to make a slightly smaller one, but whatever. We'll go with it. We can mess with it later. It's fine. So now I would extend the tower up just a little. Up and it looks. Okay. Actually, what we're gonna want to do. No, never mind. Yeah. So let's just extend the tower up a little. And this will all look 1,000 times better once we put on the roof. So now what we're gonna wanna do is actually, you know what? Let's make the tower smaller because we can actually still do that at this stage. Tower is gonna be so big and it's gonna look terrible. So, sorry about like erasing all of this work, guys, but it'll look better this way anyways, trust me. Yeah, so I'm just gonna use this as a guide. But I think we're gonna wanna make the tower center right about. Yeah, let's make this the tower center. Actually, that tower will still be kind of big. Whatever, we can deal with it. No. Let's make the tower, because we're gonna want to expand the tower later. So let's make the tower center right here. Yeah. And obviously, guys, feel free to make the tower smaller, bigger, whatever. But let's make the tower center right here. And then we'll make a support here, here. Yeah, we'll fix this up later with the roof so it looks better. Then we can get rid of the center of the tower. Actually, yeah, well, we. Just to keep it for now. Alright, then we're gonna go over here and make the other parts of the tower, other sides. Then extend these up. Okay, so now for our tower, we're gonna want to expand it out a little. So we'll just do the normal expanding. Did before. Actually, let's make it go one up at least before we expand, because the tower should look more elongated and less stumpy at our house. Let's go two up. Although, we don't want to make the tower that tall, but whatever. Then, once we've... Oh, Hexxit's really lagging for some reason. I don't even know. So many mods. There's like 63, I think. Just add two, because we don't want to make the room of the tower... Well, we basically don't want to make the tower in total that tall, so... Try to fix some of the lag by next video. Okay. So... Now that we, well, we're going to kind of be forced to carry it. It's going to look bad otherwise. Okay. So, we did that. Now for the tower, we're going to want to sort of, now this is hard because we made a very small tower, but we can still do it. So, just carry these out. Notice how I always make the frame before I start on, like, any part of the roof? I think that is the best way, because otherwise, you're going to end up making a mistake you didn't want to make with the frame, and you need to really just lay everything out so you know where it all goes. Okay. So, once again, this is just the frame. It'll make a... Oh, looks like we have a call. Sorry, guys. Well, at least the number didn't show up. Anyways, sorry, I apologize for that call. So, normally, well, yeah, I think we'll do it. We're actually, although this is going to make the tower kind of tall looking, it's going to look better if we do it this way. So, we're going to do it that way. Yeah. And normally we're going to have the tower come to a point like that, but we're not going to use oak to make it come to the point, so I'm just going to leave it like that for now, and then you'll see why when we put on the roof. So before we can start with doing the roof, we really should put the walls on the tower first, and I'm actually going to do the roof before I put the walls on this, but you'll see. Okay. So, this story, I think we'll just use Acadia again. Looks pretty nice. So, people like windows in towers. I've found that out numerous times. I personally like windows in towers. Windows in towers just look nice. It's a fact. Not really, but it's true. But, I think we're going to want to put the windows up here and then not put any windows on this level of the tower. So your tower should always have some windows, or not necessarily windows, but like a balcony or some way, you know, they can see out of the tower, get a view. Even if the view is terrible, it'll let in light, it'll look better. But probably, unless your style calls for it, you don't want to just, randomly put lots and lots of, windows on there. It'll look excessive. Alright, so we're going to grab some more wool. Yeah, we'll put on all the white wool first, then we'll do the gray. Just want to kind of randomize this. Randomizing is actually kind of hard because you always like, oh, should this go there? The key to randomizing is just not to think about it. Really, just don't think about it. If you think about it too much, just look back from a distance. If it looks decent, just go with it. Okay, so now let's put some of these here. Oh. No. Why can't I ever get that right? Okay. Yeah. is kind of a weird tower because the supports are in the middle. I've actually never made one with the supports in the middle, but I think it'll work out just fine. It might even look better, so we shall see. Now, I'm not going to do this top story just yet because we're going to want to do the roof first. And so now I'm going to show you guys how to do the roofs. So there's two things you can do with this. You can do totally nothing with this support right here. And you may have many of these types of things where it, you know, doesn't connect to another part of the roof. Don't try to bring this up and connect it to there. It'll look terrible. There is one thing you can do. Leaving it there is perfectly fine. But you can, if you want, bring it in like this, and then it'll sort of just become part of the roof. Although, honestly, I think it's best I just leave it there. You can do a more eloquent job of leading it up there, but anyways, you get the idea. Yeah. So, I think I'm gonna leave it like that. For the roof. So, I said before that we're going to do, like, red brick or something like that, so let's grab some of that stuff. Get rid of all this old stuff we have. Alright, so we have red rock, red cobblestone, red rock brick. So, I think we're going to want to go with the bricks. Yeah, that's probably going to be our best option. So let's see. So the best way to start on the roof is always just to start, a really good helpful way to do a roof, and, you definitely don't have to do this, but it helps a lot, is to make, to connect all of them with this, with oak, and I'll show you what I mean in a second. And also you want to note that the roof of the tower is not at all going to be connected with the other roofs. So normally I think I start with the smallest one, although it doesn't really matter. And then you won't be seeing this because it'll be covered with roof, but I think it will help you a ton in making your roofs, and at least it helps me a lot. And I mean, I've made quite a few roofs like this, so. And you can see this roof is gonna be, well, better than a normal survival roof because it has a lot of depth and it's not all at the same level. You never wanna make it all at the same level. That just looks bad. But you don't wanna make them varying too much. So you could have them slightly more varying than this, but honestly, it's good enough for now. So, for our roofs, we're going to want to start by going like this. And as you can see, we're going to have pretty big roofs. Okay. So, let's see why I'm doing this in a little bit. Then, you're going to want to go like this. And this works. I've actually never done it with like red brick or something like this before, but it's really nice with something like spruce. That's what I used for a lot of my like gothic or medieval houses. Or if you used spruce for this, I would recommend using maybe oak or something else for it. And then, yeah, we'll go like that. Okay. So next, you're going to want to continue out all of these things. So continuing out these things is not the easiest task ever when you start placing the stairs. So you have to kind of be careful there. But then once you start doing this, it's pretty easy. Yeah, this is going to be awesome house when we do the Hexxit survival. well, not survival, but where I just play, like a Let's Play. And there's already one episode of that, I think I mentioned it. But, yeah. Anyways, this, as you can tell, this video is already super long. But I don't want to keep it to many videos. So, I would prefer, you know, one really long, a couple, well, it's not going to be in one. We're just doing the exterior for right now. But a couple really long ones, then, you know, a ton of short ones. That's just a pain. It's actually kind of a pain for you guys to watch. So, we're going to want to do something like that. So now, you totally don't have to do this. I always do this with my Gothic style, but I'm not sure it's going to be best for this, like, sort of style. But we'll see, and we can just delete it if it doesn't look good. So, what you're going to want to do is go up one sort of section. See how there's little sections? Each section has, you know, one of these bricks coming out. And it'll, if you don't understand what I'm saying, just watch. You'll probably get it. And you're going to want to put a stair coming out like that. And then just continue it up. And this is why roofs can take quite a while, actually. But yeah, Hexxit looks awesome. And please, you know, leave some comments of things you think I could do better with this build, or other things you think I should use for this build, or in Hexxit. Other videos I should do with Hexxit, other videos I should do with Minecraft, other videos I should do, if I shouldn't do any more videos. Hopefully you won't be commenting about that, but anyways, basically anything else you would like me to do. Comments. If you liked it, I would still love to hear a comment. Let's see. So, I think I'm actually just going to leave it like this, because normally you wouldn't have, like, a really elongated red brick roof. But, if you were using, say, spruce or some other material, like wood, and you want to make, like, a really elongated Gothic-style eaves, you know, coming out, you would just go up to the next one and then do the same over here, and then just start continue it up, and then when you got, you know, you did another level, just keep continuing that. But I think we're going to be done for now. We might make this slightly more ornate, although we probably won't, but that would be in the detailing section, which will be next video. So now we're going to want to do this next one. And you always want to do all of these before you start connecting the roofs and doing the inner part. Okay, so then just add this normally, and then we'll go over here. Okay, so I promise this won't be super boring, because once we've done all of these two roofs, then we'll change into a different technique, so I'll have more to tell you guys. But for now, you can sort of just hang on, or I guess you could click on the buffer bar in below and, you know, skip ahead. But I wouldn't skip too far ahead, because you'll miss some of the techniques for making the middle of the roof and stuff. So for this one, this roof's a little different because it's more, you know, elongated. I think what we're gonna do, put one right. You always want to put one right here. Is, let's see. Oh, by the way, a technique I did cover that technique. Okay, good. Let's think. So we don't, you don't want to do this because then it looks like a staircase and that is just not visually appealing because it looks really symmetrical and it doesn't, I mean, it's not elongated and it's not, it's, you just need to add variety and that does not do it. So I think with this one, we may want to just leave it like that and not do any eaves. Because if we start, well, we can see what it looks like if we do, if we continue more on the eaves, so. And a lot of people blow off the roofs and, you know, don't spend much time on it. And, well, also, this sort of looks nice. You could just add this, but I like doing that. And then, but don't do this because it looks staircase. Okay, so... but you can actually do this. But, yeah, a lot of people blow off the roofs, and you really don't. You want to spend a ton of time on the roofs because it takes up a ridiculous amount of surface area of your project or your build or, you know, whatever. And so you need to spend some time on that. And so, okay, maybe we'll leave it with the second part like that. So let's go over here. So I'm actually sorting. At first, I didn't really like this red brick, but now I'm starting to like it a bit more, and it might actually be good, and I might use it in future builds, although probably not. I think this block is extraneous. Yeah, so this is going to be one of my longest videos yet, at least one of my... Actually, I think it is going to be my longest Minecraft video. And normally, build videos wouldn't be this long, but because this only really applies to people who have Hexxit, or people who, I mean, you could just use this with brick in Minecraft, and you'd be in normal, you know, vanilla Minecraft, you'd be totally okay. But it really only applies to a small demographic, and so I'm going to make it in one video just because I don't think it will get a ton of views if I make, you know, a ton of these. And that's also just easier for both for you and me if it's, if, you know, making the exteriors in one video and then, like, detailings in one video. Then maybe there'll be a third video where I'll make some other cool stuff. Okay, so I'm kind of doing this in random order. Like the first time I did this, I, you know, extended all of them and did it in perfect order. But now I, and obviously it doesn't matter what order you do it in. But less likely to make a mistake though if you continue with the same order. And I apologize for the lag. Normally, my Minecraft does not lag like this when I'm building. And it's totally just Hexxit. Okay, one more section thing to go here. So, should we? Yeah, I think we will. Well, I'll come back and do that. Guess I'll do it in order this time. Now you could put a half block up there, but I personally don't really like putting a half block up there. At first, just putting a block like this looks kind of clumsy, but I think it ends up looking better in the end. but once again, it totally doesn't matter. So, whatever you think. Let's see. Oh, so this block is actually extraneous. We can get rid of that. We can just use this and that. So, normally I never, ever build in the default texture pack, but I kind of had to do that for Hexxit. And also, most likely, if you have Hexxit, you're in the default texture pack, and so this should help you quite a bit. That's why I did it like this. So, let's see. And I think I'm going to be looking into some of the other mod packs on the Technic Launcher, and I probably won't have many like building videos, but I will definitely have some other, you know, Let's Plays and stuff. But who knows? I mean, I'm definitely gonna have more building videos and just, you know, normal Minecraft, or, well, I'll have creative, obviously, but you get the idea. So then we're just gonna want to extend one out. Yeah, this type of build is nearly impossible to build on survival. Because even if you did get all of these materials, I mean, none of them are super rare. Although it would take a ton of time to make all this brick. And you'd have to kill a lot of sheep. But it would be impossible to, you know, get out on this angle. You'd have to have tons and tons of, like, dirt ladders. It would be a total pain. So don't try to challenge yourself to make this in survival, because it's, I mean, I would be really impressed if someone did make something like this in survival, but really, I mean, it's kind of absurd. And once again, my intent in making this is not so, you know, someone can copy this block for block. Although, don't feel like you can't do that, just don't, like, claim credit for it. But, you know, so people can take these techniques and style, especially, you know, from making Hexxit, and then put it into their own work, you know, make something their own, similar style, but, you know, different, you know, layout. So, now we're gonna do the tower roof, and this should be kind of fun. Hope it'll be fun. Point of Minecraft is fun, right? So I'm not entirely sure what I'm doing, but doing things like this in the past have worked really well, so I'm kind of just gonna go with it. Yeah, so then we're going to want to place blocks here, I think. And then, so tip with roofs, you always want to cover up your oak supports, always. But I'm doing this because it will also add a lot of depth and probably look nicer. So that should just about cover it. Wow, this really is quite a long video. Okay, so now just maybe continue this like that. Yeah, okay, so these bricks are an interesting building material. still not quite sure if I really like them 100% or not, but whatever. Okay, so let's see. Almost done. Yeah, that should be good enough for now. Yeah. So this is getting really, really long. And so I'm actually just going to end it right here. But in the next video, we will finish the roof. And there's still, you know, a few more techniques for the roof. And then we're going to be, you know, adding detail all over the exterior. Then we're going to be creating the interior. We're going to be creating some grounds outside, maybe some dungeons or caves or something cool underneath. And so there's going to be lots of more cool stuff to come. Please comment with your feedback, all that kind of stuff. And most of all, you know, honestly, have a great day.